Okay, so I wanted to start this morning, the last day of No Time to Wait, to give a little bit of some financial information. Jerome, please correct me if any of this is wrong. but I wanted to talk about this conference and how it happens, just to kind of be transparent about that. So the three main ingredients for No Time to Wait are time, money, and love. So we need to gather that from different areas of the community to make this conference happen. So first I'm going to go into into money and love, like sponsorship. So we had received funding from these sponsors this year. So we want to share much gratitude to this list. The Netherlands Institute for Sound and Vision, RetoCH, CNA, FIAF, the National Library of Norway. And then there were many individual donations to media area that supported the conference. I think this tallied up to 6,900 euro, but as I'm looking at this slide, I think some of the donations might have been in US dollars or other currencies. So I may have tallied them all without converting the currencies from one to another. So this was what we had fundraised for to get the conference to happen. And then here are our expenses. Our expenses were quite different than what we expected because we had to transition to an online conference. We had distributed the travel grants. And then when the conference was moving into an online space, we helped coordinate with people for like canceled flights and lodgings, but some of the costs were irretrievable. So about 1,000 euros is stuck in like non-refundable travel cost. Typically we have a cost for the printing and for the dinner, which were nothing this year because the in-person conference was canceled before this could occur. And then about $200 in non-refundable travel lodging costs for the organizers. I think we still have to wait to see what the space costs for Gavertown, but we had put about 1,000 euros. In Gavertown, you pay like per person, per amount of time. So there were a couple cases where we had to increase the capacity because even though I think we had maybe 260 registrations, the maximum within the space of Gavertown was about half that, about like 125 or 130 at one time, which I thought was really good for an online conference. And then we paid for the translation, which you might have saw yesterday in a roundtable where we had it simultaneously presented in Portuguese and English. So that comes up to 2,500 euros. So obviously we have a lot of funding left over that just gets transitioned into the next conference, which I think we'll talk about at the end of the day as we close. In addition to the funding sources that I pointed out, back here, I wanted to acknowledge the project Depot, the Digital Preservation Outreach and Education Project, which did directly send travel grants to many of the attendees, even though the in-person aspect of the conference was canceled. And then for an acknowledgement of time, I want to acknowledge, media area as kind of being the administrative support of the conference, and then the Netherlands Institute for Sound and Vision, like obviously offering conference space, technical support, vision, time, coordination, even though the conference space never actually got used. But then for the organizers, presenters, and volunteers, obviously this is a lot of time. For the aspiring in-person attendees, we want to acknowledge that there were related costs to traveling and canceling plans that might not have been recoverable. And then we're obviously very grateful for all the attendees for contributing to the notes, the presentations, and the tweets. So all that kind of adds up to getting the conference to happen. Let me unshare my slides and then I don't know, Jerome, I wanted to ask you if I missed anything or if you had any comments to add, or Rasa, Laura.
And then you keep them in 1 minute because then we go on with the afternoon program.
Okay.
From my point of view, I appreciated a lot to have also sponsorship from individuals, so it is not only from institutions. And for me, it is pretty important to have different source of sponsorships and individuals. I know that it is not a small amount that they gave, and I appreciate a lot that to have different sources of sponsorship. And for sure, we have more money for the moment, but we will spend it for the next, no time to wait. So it is just a proxy for the moment, because we will not ask again to the sponsor to pay again for the next, no time to wait. We will use the money from this year.
Okay, thank you to Erwin.